Good morning, students. Today we will see our next point, that is a crystallization. See, in the last lecture we have discussed about the galvanization, what is the process of galvanization and what exactly it is happening. Okay, so today we will see a crystallization. So before to start the crystallization process, what exactly crystallization means? What? See, do you know common salt? Okay, every day we are using in our daily life. Your mother is using in a kitchen. Okay, so it is in the form of crystal. Sugar, it is also in the form of crystal. So how this means all the substance occurs? How this substance we gain? So that behind that one process, that is known as a crystallization. So first we will see what is a crystal. See, crystals means what? It is a homogeneous solid of definite geometrical shape. So crystals means what? It is in the solid state. Okay, see here, it is in a solid state and homogeneous. Homogeneous, it is a homogeneous mixture. Means what? Completely mixed to each other. Okay, so it is a homogeneous substance and solid of a definite geometrical shape. So crystals are having a definite geometrical shape. See, common salt, sugar, they are having a particular shape, that is only known as a definite geometrical shape. Then how these crystals form? See, commonly method. Now you know common salt we are getting from a CA gas, okay, by evaporation method. But that crystals are not a purest form, okay. So for that we have to perform one experiment, means one method. That method is known as a crystallization. Okay, so what we are going to do in this method? See, crystallization is the process of obtaining pure solid crystals having a definite geometrical shape. We see by the evaporation process we will get a crystals of common salt, but that is not in the purest form. And if we want in the purest form, so we have to do this crystallization method. So in this crystallization method we will get the pure substance. Okay, so for that one activity, one experiment, it is given in your textbook. Means how this process is going on, how this process we are doing. Okay, so first what we have to do, see, hot saturated solution. Now your word it is used, that is a saturated solution. Saturated solution means what? No more solute can be dissolved in that particular solution. For example, salt solution. Okay, if you will take one beaker and 5 ml water, and you have to add 2 or 3 tablespoons salt. Okay, but that salt will dissolve in that. But if you will add more in that, it will not be dissolved. Okay, that what is the reason that we already learned in a last lesson, means last year. So saturated solution means what? No more solute can be dissolved in that. That solution is known as a saturated solution. For this method, for this experiment, we need a hot saturated solution. Then what? That we have to cool it, and afterwards the slow evaporation process will take place and we will get in the form of crystals. Okay, so this activity, this experiment, crystallization, now we are going to perform here. Okay, so we will see our experiment. See, crystallization, one method it is given in your textbook. So for that what we needed, see, this is a copper sulfate, it is one chemical. Okay, this is copper sulfate. This dilute HCl means sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid. Then this is beaker, this one is stirrer, spatula, this is a dropper, and this funnel. This is known as a tripod stand. This is another beaker. And now here in this petri dish we have taken a copper sulfate powder. Okay, now we will perform the activity. See, this is wire gauze, and this is tripod stand, and this is burner. So now we perform the activity. See, first on gas. Okay, in this beaker we have to take 50 ml water, Here, marks are given 50 ml water. Okay. Then add 2 to 3 drops of dilute sulfuric acid. So for that we have to use dropper. And now with the help of this spatula, we add this copper sulfate powder in this water. Now since this water is a solvent and this copper sulfate is a solute, because this we are going to add in this water. So what we need, a hot saturated solution. So till that we have to add that no more solute can be dissolved in that. Okay, so now we will add. Then you have to stir it. Add more. How much we have to add in that no more solute can be dissolved. Now see here, round side some crystals, some copper sulfate powder is remaining. Means now it is not dissolving. So now we have to stop burner. Okay. Then this solution we have to filter it with the help of this filter paper. This is known as a filter paper. Just fold it this way. Okay. Then see this filter paper. And now this solution we have to filter it. Why we filter this solution? Because some impurities are present in the solution and we want the purest form of crystal. So first we have to filter in this solution, and now see here, you will get the filtrate. Okay, whatever is collected in this beaker, that is known as a filtrate, and insoluble impurities which will be remain here as it is on the filter paper, that is known as a residue. Now this filtrate for 5 to 6 hours we have to keep like that only, then after some times it will form a crystal. Okay. This process we have done practically, this is known as a crystallization. And see now which filtrate we collected after some hours. See in this petri dish you will see here the crystals form. Okay, and these crystals are purest form of crystal. So this whole process is known as a crystallization. In this whole lesson, what we have discussed, the physical and chemical change, what are the examples of physical and chemical change, some difference we have learned, galvanization and crystallization. So today this lesson is completed. What today homework is,
This activity, it is given in your textbook. Just write whole activity procedure as well as diagram and write your observation in your chemistry notebook. So tomorrow's period we will see our question and answers. So today we will stop here. Thank you.